Hey guys, and welcome to Neat Video's Tips and Tricks. Today we'll give you a quick tip on using Neat Video, Lumetri, and Warp Stabilizer together in Premiere Pro. We have decided to talk about this because when they're used incorrectly, Premiere Pro can become very slow or it just crashes, and you don't want any of those. Let's consider a practical example. Here I have a short clip with no effects applied. Now I'm going to add Lumetri, then Warp Stabilizer, and the last one is going to be Neat Video. Okay, Lumetri. Now Warp Stabilizer. It gives me this message, analyzing in background. I'm gonna wait. It will take a while, but that's fine. I'll speed this up in post. All done here, now it's Neat Video's turn. Now when I have Neat Video located below these two guys, I'm going to click Prepare and then Build. And Premiere Pro just hands. This has happened because of Warp Stabilizer placed before Neat Video. If I had only Lumetri, Premiere Pro wouldn't hand like this, but render and export time would still increase dramatically. Now let's open up Premiere Pro again. I'm opening the same project with the same clip. But this time, I'm going to put Neat Video first, then Lumetri, and finally Warp Stabilizer. Again, I'm getting this message and I'll wait. Okay, this is ready. Let's see what happens this time when I try opening Neat Video. Click Prepare. Then Build, and Neat Video opens up as it's supposed to. From here you can build noise profile, adjust settings, and apply them to the clip. As you could see, everything worked fine this time. But why was that happening? Why the order of the effects is so critical? Well, we have tested both Lumetri and Warp Stabilizer work with other temporal effects, not just Neat Video. And the picture was similar. If temporal effects are placed first, everything works just fine. Change them the other way around, and you will get problems. So it seems there are some limitations in both Lumetri and Warp Stabilizer when it comes to mixing them with temporal effects. Luckily, there is a workaround. With Neat Video or other temporal effects going first. Another option you could try is denoising and rendering out your clip first, and then using the clean clip in a new sequence or project to apply all the other adjustments there. Alright guys, we hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please hit subscribe button for more and give us a thumb up. If you have any questions, leave them in comments, we'll be happy to help. And bye for now.